Hi, and welcome to this video on the How Do I series of Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. My name is Koen Stocks, I'm a Microsoft certified trainer, and I work for Platan, which is a training partner located in Belgium. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to instruct a bank to execute payments based on the due date in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. So at the end of this video, you will have an overview of the different options to instruct a bank when to execute payments to vendors. The objectives of this video is introduce the function to create payment lines where the applies to document number due date is used as posting date. I will do this by demonstrating three different scenarios. First, I will use the suggest vendor payments batch without this function and review the results. Next, I will run the batch once again, but now with the calculate posting date from applies to document number due date field selected. And I will then review the difference with the first batch. Finally, I will also demonstrate the function to offset the due date. When you use the payment journal to pay vendors, the posting date of the payment journal line is the date on which the vendor will be paid. So, for example, when you create an electronic payment file from the payment journal, the system will take the date from the posting date field and insert it as dispatch date in the electronic payment file. As default, when you create payment lines using the suggest vendor payments batch, this date is automatically filled with the work date in the system. However, you can easily change this to the due date of the document that you are paying. In my demonstrations, I will specifically focus on using these functions. If you want to find out how to use the payment journal in general, please refer to one of the other How Do I videos on cache management in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. In my first demonstration, I will use the suggest vendor payments batch as default, resulting in a number of payment lines carrying all the same posting date, which is my system's work date. So in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2, I will go to the payment journal and run the suggest vendor payments batch. As last payment date, I will use the 31st of January 2015. The posting date is the 22nd of January 2015, which is my system's work date. I will enter the starting document number and I will click on OK. As a result, you can see now that all the lines in my payment journal have the same posting date, so these vendors will be paid on the 22nd of January 2015. However, instead of paying all these invoices on the same date, companies can benefit from paying vendor invoices on their due dates. Let me demonstrate how to do this in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. In the payment journal, I will go to the suggest vendor payments batch. I will use the same last payment date and posting date as in my previous demonstration. However, now I will select the field calculate posting date from applies to document due date. I will enter the starting document number and I will click on OK. As a result, you can see now payment lines with different posting dates. For example, the first payment line is a payment to Progressive Home Furnishing for an amount of 199,000. If I go to the apply entries overview, you can see that this invoice has a due date of the 31st of January 2015. And as a result, you will see now that this payment line carries the posting date of the 31st of January 2015, so the document's due date. If I take another example, for example this line, a payment to London Postmaster, you can see that the amount is 8,132. If I go again to the apply entries overview, you will see in this case that the due date is the 31st of December 2014. So you will see that in these situations, the posting date of the payment line will be the same as the work date. Finally, I will also demonstrate how to use the due date offset function in the suggest vendor payments batch. In the payment journal, I will go to suggest vendor payments. I will use the same last payment date and posting date, and I will also select the calculate posting date from applies to document due date field. But now I will also enter a date formula in the applies to document due date offset field. So for example, it could be possible for cash flow purposes that I want to pay all invoices 5 days later than their due dates. So if I enter plus 5D, and if I now enter starting document number, you will see that NAV add 5 days on top of the due date and use this as posting date. In my previous example, the first line had a posting date of the 31st of January 2015, which was the document's due date, and now the posting date is the 31st of January plus 5 days, so resulting in the 5th of February. You can also enter a negative date formula. In the applies to document date offset field, I have now entered minus 2 days, and as a result, the posting date of my payment lines will be the due date of the document minus 2 days. If I take again the first line as an example, in my previous demonstration, the posting date was the 31st of January 2015, so once again the document's due date, but now it's the 29th of January 2015, which is the document's due date minus 2 days. In this video, I have demonstrated how to instruct a bank to execute payments based on the due date in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2. Thank you for watching this video. My name is Koen Stocks and I hope to welcome you on one of the other videos on the How Do I series on Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2013 R2.